it, but I preach a priest according to the order of Melchizedek. And I want to bring you into fellowship with the supernatural. I want to bring you into fellowship with the other world. When you are on this earth, he preached heaven. On earth, he said, even us, we are seated in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, in the first church age. Hallelujah. Hey. He is preaching these things. He says, I was caught up in a dimension where I saw things that are forbidden men to utter. So when he came down, he was writing the things in mystery form. Do you see what I'm saying? And then there came another man. And then there came the third man that saw also God in his pre-incarnate nature. But because the mysteries had already been spoken and had been encoded in the Bible in mystery form, he came to tie the loose ends. Truth that was declared in mystery form was being preached in plain view. But God said, I am not going to allow this work to be handled of men. I am allowing this work to be handled of God himself. So God has to come down and veil himself in a Kentucky prophet. And start declaring the unsearchable riches in plain view that the Melchizedek that Paul was speaking about is the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Are you with me? Just like the Son of Man was revealed in the east, he's got to be revealed in the west. And where does the sun set? In the west. And when the sun is setting, it's evening time. And during evening time, God comes down for fellowship. So there's got to be a witness in the end time. Hallelujah. There's got to be somebody that sees God also in his original form. There's got to be somebody that takes a photo with him in the original form. There's got to be somebody that speaks of him in present tense. Hallelujah. And you might feel associated because you hunted with him, but that does not make you and bring you into fellowship. Many hunted with the prophet and today they are pets eaten. Because they didn't see beyond the veil of flesh. Hallelujah. They saw a common brother. They saw a common pastor. They saw a common believer. I'm going to bring it home. I'm going to bring it home. It's easy to believe a dead prophet. It's very easy to believe a dead prophet than to believe a living Tinashe. Hallelujah. This brother from Zimbabwe, he doesn't even know how to dress properly. God is challenging on the veil of flesh. And I too am a witness. Hallelujah. And I've come to declare the unsearchable riches of God that you also may be a witness and can come to the fellowship of the mystery. I feel religious. You think that was William Branham preaching? You missed it. You missed it. That's why they like talking about issues of hunting. They don't like to talk about the message. They dispute the cloud based on seasons and time and what February. No!
No, sir, no, sir.
You are missing it. You are missing it. This cloud is called the ring of mystery. Hallelujah! Bringing us into the fellowship and the company of angels. Today we are candidates of association with angelic beings. I don't fellowship with mortal. I fellowship with the supernatural dimension. Hallelujah! Speaking lip to ear with God. You stumble in the faith. You stumble in the body. Hallelujah. It was in the days of Isaac. He had two sons, Esau and Jacob. And then Esau was a bit nice guy, too nice. You know, those two nice guys, he's always at home. He's always doing the right thing. But he was not the chosen. The Bible says, Esau have I hated. Even before he was formed in his mother's womb. Your looks does not qualify you to be elect. Whether you lived in 1965 doesn't qualify you to be elect. Whether you've been in the message for 40 years doesn't qualify you to be raptured material. Hallelujah! I want to hear the voice. I want to hear the voice. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let me hear the voice. Praise God. Can you bring me that quotation on... or looking at the unseen. I want to see. I want to hear the voice. So Isaac calls his two boys. He calls them up. He says, boys, come here. I want to bless you. And then the mother heard that, no. This is, right there, just leave it there. He says, your father wants to bless you. Esau, you've got to make a plan. Do you see what I'm saying? I want you to see that when you want to come into the fellowship of the mystery, you have to look beyond the veil of flesh. So he had to fake Esau's fame. He had to come like as him as Esau was. Do you see what I'm saying? So the father was partially blind. So he touched. He said, how are you, my son? And he said, I'm all right, father. He says, the body is of Esau, but the voice is not of Esau. And we have received a message. And I want to invite a preacher for 17 seconds. I want you to listen to this. Never in the picture. These are not the books arms and pray the prayer. This is the voice of God. This is the voice of Jehovah. I have not believed a man. I believe Christ. Hallelujah. Christ and Christ alone. And he came and declared these things to us. And we are part of that. We are part of the mystery. We have not hunted with him, Pastor. We were not there when they were hunting. We don't know about the Kalipu. We don't know about whatever. But we have seen it also. And you know what? We have believed it. And we have become one with it. Hallelujah. So what Brother Brennan say? I believe it and that settles it. Hallelujah. I believe it and that settles it. He says now this has the shortest edge. Don't calculate with your own watch. I believe it's the shortest. Hallelujah. I believe it's the shortest. He says there's gonna be a bride without spot, without wrinkle. Hallelujah. I believe there's gonna be a bride. But I'm still in sickness. I don't care. There's gonna be a bride. But I'm still lying. I don't care. You're gonna be made perfect in the midst of Satan's eating. We are gonna have perfection. Hallelujah. We're gonna strike perfection. And when we strike perfection, we hit the resurrection. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Then without us, we cannot be made perfect. Paul is waiting on you. Paul is waiting for you. Why would you call it? Brother Branham is waiting on you. Brother Branham himself is waiting for you to hit perfection. You have a responsibility to catch the mystery and come into fellowship. Come into fellowship with you, not with me, with God, with Jehovah, with the spoken word. That spoken word is God himself, speaking and thundering through mortal lips. Hallelujah. Adam must be strong with three things.
I like that, brother. That's my kind of preaching.
Adam had three things in the garden. He had eternal life, he had dominion, and he had fellowship. He's new, I'm not gonna die. I'm living my life. God has given me dominion. He would work on the earth. In the cool of the day, God would come down. Sit down, talk to Adam. How are you, Adam? Lord, I'm okay. I want to teach you a secret in prayer. Prayer is you, it's not you telling God whatever, and then you will stand up and walk away. Wait. When you pray, wait. Yes. No, brother, I was so anointed on Friday. I prayed for an hour. And how many minutes did you wait after you prayed for an hour? Wait to hear back from God. I was staying with a family in Pretoria. They were praying this other afternoon. It was two sisters praying. So I had gone to town. And then I came, I didn't come back at that time. So they thought I came back. And they were praying on sacrificial hours. In the afternoon they started praying and praying and praying. So they said, just when we were about to finish, we had the door opened. And we obviously thought it was you, Brother Tinashe, that came. Says, and but you came with an eloquent voice. We were praying in eloquence. Says, so we prayed. Because we felt like you were just arriving. You might also want to pray a little bit with us. Says, so we continued with him. You see. He says, until we felt like, we can't cope with this man. He is going and going. He says, so we kept quiet. And we heard you kept praying for us. You kept praying for us. You kept praying for us. He says, and then we joined again. Says, when we joined again, then you kept quiet. And then the other sister finished, and the other one said amen. When they opened their eyes, they saw there were just the two of them. There was no dead person. They were so scared to even ask each other. So they just stood and started knocking on my door. Brother Tinashe, there's no Brother Tinashe. He opened the door, they saw them, so they thought maybe he prayed and they went out. But they realized, no. We are in fellowship with the mystery. Once in a while, the angels come to join us in worship. Once in a while, the angels come to join us when we are driving our cars. Once in a while, the angels come when we are preaching this message. We have seen even pictures. We have seen videos of the dove flying here. Fellowship with the mystery. When you come into fellowship with a supernatural dimension, you don't want your life to go on the low. Because you have known him in another dimension. Let me find where I can put the round up to a close. So Adam lost that in the Garden of Eden. And God had to bring a peace offering. He had to bring a peace offering. Now a peace offering is when God is the host. And what is a peace offering for? Is to destroy, to cut the enmity between God and man. Because man had failed God. So God is trying to bring you back. And what does a table resemble? Because God is calling you, come let us have a feast. He spreads a table. And a table resembles communion. And a table resembles fellowship. So God is saying, now come in this evening time. There is a peace offering. I want you to come back so that we can speak, live to hear again. I want to speak to you as my children, and I want you to hear. And the prophet says, once more shall hear from God. They shall hear from God again after he has gone. And he says in another instance, Pastor, I was touching it. And I said, Lord, you should not go to my heart. He says, I'm going to come back. I am going to return. But he's not going to return as William Branham in the flesh. He says, I will ride this train again. Hallelujah. In other words, Jehovah shall speak to the people again. But this time, he shall speak through the fivefold ministry. God is being simplified. And the more he's being simplified, the more he's becoming complicated.
Amen.
When you are busy wailing and weeping, oh Lord, how I wish I had lived in the days of Brother Branham. Brother, you're busy. All these questions and answers, all these things that I just want something to be clear. I don't even know, brother. All these questions, I don't know, Lord, whether a black man should marry a white woman, because God is the creator of all the people. If only Brother Branham was around. That's what's concerning you, marrying a white woman. Of all the questions and answers you could want to ask, have you ever seen most of the questions that people ask were more on the kind of things? Brother Branham, should we trim the edges of what about a sister that wants to just put a gold tint on the other side? We just want to paint our nails a little bit. He says, you know what? I don't have a scripture for those things. But you know what? If you have a question about it, it means it's wrong, isn't it? The reason why it's bothering you is you're trying to beat your conscience. The prophet says, if you're in doubt, do without. Because you have, they were never asking questions like, Brother Branham, should we pray more? Do you see what I'm saying? Because they know they must pray more. Should we read more? They didn't ask those things. What about a sister that is wearing this winner skirt? Those kind of things. So the more God is being simplified, the more he's becoming complicated. And God is simplified so that you can miss him if you are not predestinated.
Amen.
Do you see what I'm saying? So, That's why before that revelation of the seven seals, God preached the message, God hiding himself in simplicity. Do you see what I'm saying? He was saying, what I am going to preach, whatever is going to have controversies. Because today people preach too much controversy on the book of the seventh seal. But before that book was preached, he says, God is now going to hide himself in simplicity. And in one of the visions, Junior Jackson saw that that man with the crowbar hit the rock, and then the top of the rock was taken off, and there was a white stone on top, and there were inscriptions there. And then the prophet says the brothers came from different parts. He says, just look. Look on it, I'm going to west, and I'm going to come back with the Holy Ghost. Do you see what I'm saying? So they were standing there. Because the mystery that is going to come from the white rock. Remember, the white and the no inscriptions, it means the sun had never shone on it. And the sun is revelation. So there was no revelation on it as yet. So you can look at the white rock, but as long as the sun has not shone on it, whatever you are preaching is man's idea. You have to wait for the man that went west to come back with the Holy Ghost. In other words, the revelation of the white rock cannot be preached until the Holy Ghost comes. He says, but while I was still going, I looked at the corner of my eye. Brother so-and-so had a chat already. He's already preaching those things. This brother had gone already. This brother had gone already. This brother had gone already. But a few waited and were looking at the white rock. He says, and I came with the interpretation of it. This is the revelation of it. It's all about Jesus Christ. Someone to come know his brother, so and so. No. You left before the sun shone. Someone to say, no, it's this, that, and the other. Wait, just wait. When the Holy Ghost comes, you will see that revelation to Genesis is speaking about one man. The message of the hour is not a religion. The message of the hour is a person. And the person of the message of the hour is the Lord Jesus Christ. So if you believe the message and you find yourself following a man, you have not believed the message. Because the message points you. The message points you. Because I will send you to forerun the coming of. I don't send you to forerun the coming of another brother. No, sir. Not the coming of another great minister. No, sir. Not the coming of another eighth messenger. No, sir. But the coming of. That's why you must take the picture to the right. Well, the client does not exist. Turn it to the right. Who do you see? If you see a brother there, then I'm leaving this message. If you see an apostle there, then I'm leaving this message. The same one is the same one. I can see his eyes. I can see his nose. I can see his mouth. And he is speaking. He is commenting. Hallelujah! He is commenting. And Pastor, God came in the evening time to commend his creation. And he said, this is good. This is good. This is good. On the sixth day, he gave two goods. He says, this is very good. Hallelujah. A double portion. Because on the seventh day, the revelation of Christ should be in plain view. So, who you are called to come in fellowship with? It's not brothers and sisters. It's Christ. It's Christ. It's Christ. And when you understand Christ, you will know that he's behind the veil, the flesh of brothers and sisters. Christ is in me. Christ is in you. You are not going to believe in God in heaven if if you can't believe the God in your brother. That's why you cannot make it to the rapture by staying at home and listening to the tape. You will not make it. You can have a heap of tapes. That's unscripture. I'm sorry, I have to declare this. The Bible says the fivefold ministry is given for the edification of the church and the perfection. So there is no perfection without the fivefold ministry.
Amen.
My pastor is Brother Branham. I said it's easy to believe a dead prophet. While he was alive, they refused. It's easy for you to believe him because he's dead. But when we present you with a living word preached by a living brother and you denied it, then you have rejected the word of your hour. Because the message is present and continuous. Blessed be the Lord God Almighty, who is, was, and is to come. You want to see him in the past is and the is to come, but you don't want to see him in the is of today. And today God is speaking to you that come out of him, of them. Now them is no longer the denomination. Them is your five senses of the spirit and five senses of the flesh. Come out of them, my people. In other words, he's calling to the soul to come and fight the spirit and fight the flesh so that the soul can be in fellowship with the Lord Jesus Christ. That is the mystery of the seventh seal. In the revelation of the mystery of the seventh seal, the prophet talks about baptism with all sensation. He says that happens in the soul. It doesn't happen on the flesh. It doesn't happen on the spirit. It happens in the soul. And then some brother comes and says, you know what? I've received the baptism without sensation, so I'm no longer aiming in the wind. We are done with the days of sensation. That's not what we are saying. We are saying when God touches you with the baptism without sensation, it will manifest on your spirit. It will manifest on your flesh. It will show the God that is inside of you. Because when God came down the mountain, when he was coming to see Moses, he worshipped himself. God worshipped himself. Now I want to tell you something. God is not in a crisis to be worshipped. To those that feel pressured, when we say worship God, I want to give you free information. God doesn't have a shortage of worshipers. So if you don't want, don't be the best touch person that you can ever be. You are going to dance when you are in hell. In heaven, the prophet said there was a lady that came to him. He says, I can't hold on with this bunch. It's too noisy. He says, my sister, I'm sorry to tell you this. You're going to have trouble. Because in heaven, there's going to be noises. And in hell, there's going to be noises. So while you are still on this side, choose the side of your noise. Tell you to worship, you are going to see the mystery, that the mystery has got worship packaged in it. Let it be on earth as it is in heaven. Do you know what it is in heaven? Father, let it be on earth as it is in heaven. Then you see two fold ones. You don't know what it is in heaven. In heaven, the sisters are not wearing high heel shoes. They are walking barefooted. That's why you see those with flat shoes, they can praise better. Because they are not minding their step. Do you see what I'm saying? And you are saying, I'm not worshiping because I'm an elder. The Bible says, and the 20 and 4 elders filled up and worshiped God. So from the young to the old, when you come to the fellowship of the mission, you will worship God. You will praise God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And when do you worship Him? Before you have your breakthrough. Children of Israel were told to blow their trumpets and to start shouting before the walls of Jericho were fallen. So this afternoon, before you are filled with the Holy Ghost, shout. Before you've got your house, shout. Before you are delivered from drugs, shout. Before your cancer has been destroyed, shout. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Before your marriage comes, shout. Hallelujah. Brother Tinashe, I want to be married. Shout now before the marriage comes. Brother Tinashe, I want money in my account. Shout now before the money comes. Brother Tinashe, I want intelligence at school. Shout now before intelligence comes. Brother Tinashe, I want peace in my marriage. Shout now before peace comes. Hallelujah. Shout. Shout. The walls of Jericho are falling tonight. The walls of Jericho are being dismantled. Hallelujah. Come to the fellowship of the mystery. Hallelujah. We have seen His star and have come to worship Him. Who was His star? William Branham. Hallelujah. And what was the star holding? The light of God. The light of Jehovah. I am the one that is speaking. Brother Branham has nothing to do with it. I am speaking through His voice. I am the one that filled Jesus with the Holy Ghost. I am the one that sent Christ to die for you. Who am I? Jehovah. And what am I saying? Shout. Before your breakthrough, shout. Hallelujah. Before you receive power, shout. And when the day of Pentecost is fully come, they will start coming in the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. You can't hold yourself. You can't hold yourself. Jeremiah says, it's like fire shut in my bones. I feel it everywhere. I feel it in my arms. I feel it in my feet. I feel it on my pillow. Hallelujah. I believe the Bible from cover to cover. I believe it. I believe the cover also. And the cover says, Holy Bible. And you are not slaves, but you are free. You are free. Free from men's ideas. Free from denominationalism. Free from sickness. Free from poverty. Free from Laodicea. I set an open door between Philadelphia and Laodicea as a way of escape. But before you enter in, shout. Shout. Give Him praise and glory in the highest. He is here. He is here. Let's see who can entertain the king. Hallelujah. Michelle tried to stop David. And David said, hey woman, leave me. I'm going to dance. I'm going to dance like David danced. I'm going to sing like Miriam sing. Give me the tambourine. It's time for a new song. Hallelujah. As the musicians come up, it's time for a new song. It's time for a new song. Every revelation, every paradox, every exodus comes with a new song. Hallelujah. From virgin one to virgin. Can't you hear? Your theophany is calling you. It's a sign. It's homecoming time. I am going home. I am going home. I am going home. I don't belong to earth. I'm going back to God. Where I come from, I have seen Him. I have manifested Him. He is speaking to you this afternoon. If you can take Him at His word, all things are possible. All things are possible. All things are possible. Demons are leaving this place. Satan is leaving this place. Satan, out. out of this place. Out of this place. Sickness out. Out of this place. Spirit of fornication out. Adultery out. Out of this church. Out of this church. They are going to be pure. They are going to be holy. Without spots. Without wrinkle. From the soul, freedom from the inner man, freedom to overcome all the circumstances, overcome the boss at work, overcome the unbelieving husband, the unbelieving wife, the wayward children. God is calling them back again. The Holy Ghost is an enforcer. We are declaring it as we have seen it. I am a witness. I am a witness. I have seen cancers disappear. I have seen eyes open. I have seen the cripple walk. You are going to 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 walk. You shall rise. Jerusalem shall rise again. Jerusalem walls shall be built in troublous times. Oh, hallelujah! 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 Praise God! Praise Him! Praise Him! Praise Him! Worship Him! Worship Him! Worship Him! Worship Him! Worship Him! Worship Him! Jerusalem is rising. Babylon is falling. Babylon has fallen. Babylon has fallen. Shalom. New Jerusalem. Praise God. Praise Him in the highest. Praise Him.
Oh, let's worship Him this afternoon. Let's stand and worship the Lord this afternoon. our hearts back to the fellowship. We'll turn our hearts back to the faith of the forefathers. We thank God that these divine revealed mystery truths has opened up our understanding. Our eyes has been enlightened to the word of the hour. Amen. I don't know about you, but I was blessed. This is my kind of preaching. I like that. Amen. Where I can be free and just worship and just amen the Lord. One thing that you must understand is that when the word is being preached, the word corrects the error. We don't preach against somebody or about a people or about a church. The word corrects the error. So let the preacher come, discern his spirit, and I can tell you, Brother Tanasha's spirit is clean. So he was used of the Holy Ghost. He preached. And let me tell you, it's not the veil, it's beyond the veil. It's the Shekinah glory, veil and flesh again. If you were in the service this morning, you would know exactly what the brother was preaching about. Because I feel tonight was a continuation of this morning. Because it's the same Spirit of God, the same Spirit of Christ speaking again. So we want to salute our brother Tanashe. We want to say a job well done. Amen. God bless you, Richie.